Hey guys, welcome back to Super Top 10s. Today we'll talk about two fattest chefs on the planet. Let's head into it. Number 2, Mario Batali. Mario Batali, full-grown Mario Francisco Batali, born on September 19, 1960, Seattle, Washington, USA, is an American chef, TV personality, author, and a restauranter who was one of the early 21st century's most famous food celebrities. While growing up surrounded by accomplished home cooks in his family, Batali developed a passion for cooking, especially during his visits to his grandmother's house in Seattle, where he was immersed in traditional Italian cooking. He enrolled at Le Cordon Bleu Cooking School in London after graduating from Rutgers State University of New Jersey in 1982, but he quickly withdrew and instead trained under the soon-to-be famous London chef Marco Pierre White, before moving to a small northern Italian village in 1989, where he spent 3 years learning the nuance of traditional Italian cuisine. Batali worked in a series of kitchens in Europe and the United States.
You're worried about my superior presentation crushing you.
No, it's good. It's gonna be great.
Okay.
All right.
In 1993, a small trattoria in New York City was opened by Batali and a partner Steve Crane. 5 years later, when the two opened New York City's Babbo Ristorante Enoteca, Batali's signature restaurant, he started a fruitful partnership with the restaurant Joe Bastianich, with whom Batali would later open more than a dozen additional restaurants around the world as a part of Batali and Bastianich Hospitality Group. It was named the best new American restaurant in 1998 by the James Beard Foundation. While his star was rising in the culinary world via his appearances on televised cooking programs, he gained much more fame.
What? Cheese is melting because I know, you know why it has an artificially low temperature? Because it's not made of milk.
The heavy bearded Batali kept his long hair in a ponytail and almost always wore a shirt and bright orange molded clogs. His idiosyncratic appearance, which helped him to stand out among the dozen of television personalities who rose to prominence in the 1990s and the early 2000s with the popularization of food-based programming. Other notable television appearances by Batali included Iron Chef American Cooking Competition, where he was one of the original Iron Chefs of the program from 2005 until the departure of the show in 2009. Spain On the Road Again, 2008, a country travelogue featuring Batali and a group of his celebrity friends, and The Chews, daytime talk and cooking show, 2011 to 2017. Recently revealed that he weighs at least 240 pounds at present, which is a decent weight. That said, he used to weigh a lot more actually, but he lost a lot of his weight.
Tomato and vodka have gone together
perfectly.
Like the Bible and Christianity.
Number 1. Emeril Lagasse. Emeril Lagasse is a celebrity chef, best known for his product lines and restaurants, and his catchphrase as the host of the television show Emeril Live. Emeril Lagasse, the chef, restauranter, and TV personality, was born on October 15, 1959, in a small town of Fall River, Massachusetts, where his French-Canadian father, Emeril Jr., and his Portuguese mother, Hilda, were raised. The teenage Lagasse developed a passion for cooking while working at a local Portuguese bakery. He enrolled at DeMond Vocational High School in the culinary arts program in 1973. Lagasse also led the high school drum squad as a talented percussionist playing at dances and at numerous local religious festivals.
I mean, I don't know why it's become that, but it's become this, food as a competition.
In 1990, in New Orleans, Emeril Lagasse opened his first restaurant. Lagasse began to appear on the Food Network a few years later, finally securing his own show, Emeril's Ascents and Emeril Live. Lagasse has built an empire of his products and restaurants, in addition to television. Lagasse was offered a full scholarship to the New England Conservatory of Music upon his graduation from the high school, but decided to pursue a career as a professional chef. At Johnson & Wales University in Providence, Rhode Island, he spent the next year training. Lagasse took a job in a local restaurant in order to pay for his tuition, where he met fellow student Elizabeth Keefe. The two were married in October 1978, a few months after Lagasse had finished working on his course, before returning to the United States, where he spent the next few years working in fine restaurants throughout the Northeast. Lagasse polished his skills in Paris and Lyon, France.
How is Emeril as a dad? Was he the softy or was he the toughy?
He tries to be the toughy, but you're a teddy bear.
In 1986, Lagasse and his wife divorced, at which Elizabeth moved back to Massachusetts with their two children. Lagasse recently endorsed his own line of cookware called Emerilware. In addition to his hectic TV schedule and restaurant empire, which now includes 6 establishments, as well as 4 best-selling cookbooks named Louisiana Real and Rustic 1996, Emeril's Coral Christmas 1997, Emeril's TV Dinners 1998, 1998, and Every Day is a Party, 1999. Lagasse's other endeavors include regular guest appearances on Good Morning America. Lagasse appeared in May 2000 on a wildly popular game show, Who Wants to Be a Millionaire, where he donated his winnings of $125,000 to a charity of children with learning disabilities in New Orleans. Lagasse was married to the fashion designer Tari Han from 1989 to 1996. He married his third wife, Eldon Lovelace, a real estate broker, and his daughter, Mary Lovelace Lagasse, and his son, EJ, born in March 2003. There is no precise information about his weight, but it is rumored that he weighs about 300 pounds, which is actually a great deal. It's his body, and with it, he can do anything he wants. But certainly, we'd advise him to start doing some sport and implement a healthier meal plan. So, what do you think about these chefs? Were you shocked about their weight? Let us know in the comments below. This brings us to the end of our video. I hope you enjoyed it. Hit like if you did, and don't forget to subscribe to our channel so you never miss out on any of our videos in the future. Also, watch the two videos that are on your screen because I'm sure you'll love them. With that, I'll see you in the next video.